So we've got 2 minutes on cosmetic lighting. Someone had asked, why do we use red lighting, pink lighting at the head of the casket or above where the person is laid for visitation and viewing? It's pretty simplistic, really. When someone dies, they get pale because the blood moves to the lowest part of the body, which is to the back of the head, and it often leaves the skin looking much less ruddy, which is that reddish coloring. And so during the embalming process, we can restore a little bit of the pink hues and the red hues and the orange hues to the skin, but not always. So these pinkish hued lights help cast a little pinkish hue onto the person being viewed. Let's call it like an Instagram filter type thing, that it's going to give a little smooth freshness to the look. Not so much masks, but just helps balance the color of someone. Now, back in the day when viewings were in homes, you would bring in the torchier lights because old houses didn't have can lights and overhead lights. If you go into an old house or live in an old house, you own a lot of lamps because there was no in-ceiling lights usually, or there was maybe one little one. So they would bring in the torchiers to set at the end of the viewing area or the couch that the person was being laid out on. And so what they would do then, because the body was typically very pale, they would put in red bulbs into those torchiere lights to give that reddish, ruddy, you know, healthier glow, I guess, if you want to say healthy, talking about deceased, but that healthier glow to the deceased when they're being viewed. So it's all about cosmetics. It's all about just kind of trying to restore without doing much to the actual person themselves. So cosmetic lighting.